good afternoon and welcome to your new English lesson. Dobar dan, dobrodošli u vašu novu video lekciju. Dobrodošli u moj park, zeleni. Veoma je lijep, nadam se da vam se dopada. Tek sad počinjem da shvatam prednosti zelenila, ptičica i drveća. Ranije mi to nije bilo baš mnogo bitno. U svakom slučaju, ono što sam htjela da kažem pre nego što krenemo sa lekcijom jeste da sam razmišljala o tome kako mnogo đaka kaže nisam talentovan za jezik i zbog toga ne mogu da naučim jezik. Moj odgovor na to jeste da je to izgovor. Dakle, talent jeste bitan, možda i ključan ako hoćete da se bavite jezikom na nekom visokom nivou, ako hoćete da pišete neko književno delo ili nešto na engleskom, ali ako hoćete da naučite da se izražavate na engleskom, na početnom, srednjem pa i višem nivou, ono što je potrebno je strpljenje, upornost i pravi način rada, pravi način učenja. A šta to znači? Pa to znači da ne izgubite vreme učeći na različite načine, koristeći različite metode, čitajući različite knjige, gledajući različite klipove i da na kraju dođete i kažete evo ja sam učio 8 godina u srednjoj školi, u osnovnoj školi 4 godine u srednjoj školi i da na kraju ne znate da prevedete rečenicu gde si bio. Prevedete where did you be. Znači, to mi se dešavalo milion puta na raznim testiranjima u školi kada dođu đaci da se priključe nekim časovima i onda prevedu recimo where did you be, a pritom dođu i kažu ja sam B1 i tako dalje. Kako biste preveli gde si bio? Where were you? Gde si bio, da. A zašto se to dešava? Pa to se dešava zato što mi se trudimo da naučimo sve, sva glagolska vremena koja postoje i tako dalje, a samim tim ne naučimo ništa, logično. Dakle, budite modest, skromni, nemojte se truditi da naučite sve. Evo sad mu kažete, ja ću naučiti prezent i prošlo vreme. To mi je dovoljno. Ali da naučim baš kako treba. Dakle, zato mislim da su recimo ove rečenice jedan od načina koje vam ja predlažem da učite da biste znali šta učite. Dakle, recite sebi, evo naučit ću ovih 15 rečenica u present simple tense, naučit ću ih savršeno, da znam da ih prevedem, da znam da ih pročitam, da znam da ih prebacim u neko drugo lice, da znam da postavim pitanje, da odgovorim na pitanje. Dakle, skoncentrišite se samo na jednu stvar, naučite jednu stvar, pa tek onda krenite na nešto drugo. To pretpostavljam i sami znate, ali se nekad ne pridržavamo toga, nego jednostavno možda nam i dosadi jedan tisti materijal iz koga radimo, pa onda kažemo, ma daj da krenem da učim nešto drugo. Dakle, nemojte, držite se jednog dok ne naučite. Imam tu neku upornost što se tiče tih učenja jezika i mogu. I nije mi dosadno i nije mi glupo da ponavljam jednu istu stvar 100 puta. I čak se moja profesorka recimo grčkog čudi kako mogu toliko puta da isponavljam jednu isto. Ali ja znam da bez tog ponavljanja ne mogu da idem dalje. Dakle, ona je posle recimo nekog 10. časa meni rekla, ajde da učimo prošlo vreme. Ja sam probala jedan čas da radim to prošlo vreme iz grčkog i onda sam shvatila da mi je preteško. Znači, da mi nije došlo vreme za to. Nisam sazrela za prošlo vreme. Ja sam se vratila na prezent i recimo učila možda još neke nove glagole, ali ih i dalje menjala samo u prezentu i pravila rečenice samo u prezentu i onda je odjednom sam shvatila da sad mogu da krenem na prošlo vreme i tek kad sam ja bila spremna, prešli smo na prošlo vreme i naravno sad znam i prošlo vreme na grčkom. Dakle, nemojte se truditi da budete neki što viši nivo ili da kažete ja sam A2, ja sam C2, ja sam B1, već se trudite da budete na nižem nivou što je duže moguće, zato što ćete onda mnogo brže te ostale nivoe savladati. Pomažem vam sa rečenicama, ja mislim čisto da vam dajem neku smernicu kako da učite, na koji način da učite. Naravno, pišite mi u komentarima šta biste još, kako biste još želili da učite, pa možemo da sarađujemo. Dajte mi ideje za klipove. To je to, a sada krećemo sa novim klipom.
Can you speak openly with me? Well, of course, why not? I trust you. I can tell you everything. Can you speak openly with me? Do you do any sports? Actually, not. I'm a bit lazy. Do you think I should do some sports? Do you do any sports? Don't you have free time today? Sorry, even though it's Sunday, I don't have free time today. Don't you have free time today? Are you paying for that? Sorry, I can't pay for that. I forgot my wallet at home. Are you paying for that? You have done everything incorrectly. So sorry. My concentration was not very good. You have done everything incorrectly. You are very funny today. Oh, thank you very much. I'm always funny. You are very funny today. I'm not afraid of anything. What about you? What are you afraid of? I'm not afraid of anything. Thanks a lot for your help. Oh, don't mention it. You're welcome. Thanks a lot for your help. Thanks a lot for your gift. Oh, it was nothing. I know that you like flowers. That's why I bought you some flowers. Thanks a lot for your gift. She has a lot of nice dresses. Yes, she does. I know. She is a famous actress. She needs to have nice dresses. She has a lot of nice dresses. Do you want to scare me? Why are you wearing that scary mask? Do you want to scare me? Who will she invite to the party? Well, I don't know, but I know one thing. She won't invite me. She's angry with me. Who will she invite to the party? Until when did you work? I worked until late. I worked until 11 o'clock. Until when did you work? What do you dream of? I dream of going on holiday. What do you dream of? He was awarded for that book. Really? I didn't hear that, but I've read a book and it's great. He was awarded for that book. My efforts have been rewarded. I've done so much work. I've been hardworking and my efforts have been rewarded. A reward was offered. They offered a reward to anyone who has some information about him. Really? A reward was offered? His face was white as a sheet. He was so scared and pale. His face was white as a sheet. I closed the book I was reading. When she entered the room, I closed the book I was reading. I closed the book I was reading. It was time to go to bed. What time did you go to bed? I went to bed at midnight. It was 12 o'clock and it was time to go to bed. Is the light still on? I don't know. I can't see his window from here. Is the light still on? Is the door closed? Yes, it is. I checked. Don't worry. The door is closed. Is the door closed? Sorry, it was stupid of me. How could you do that? You embarrassed me. Sorry, it was stupid of me. He jumped over the hedge. How did your dog get here? Well, he jumped over the hedge. My dog jumped. His horse jumped over the fence. He's a rider. He can ride a horse. And his horse jumped over the fence. Is this couch new? I haven't seen it before. When did you buy it? Is this couch new? Are these flowers for me? Oh, thank you very much. I love flowers. Are these flowers for me? I quickly tried to change the subject. She started talking about her ex-husband and I quickly tried to change the subject. Is the furniture new? Yes, we have a new flat and we bought new furniture. Is the furniture new? We bought new furniture. Really? Where did you get the money for the new furniture? We bought new furniture. The furniture was dusty. We rented a flat. It was an old flat. And the furniture was all dusty. We needed to clean it. When will we be there? Well, it takes only half an hour to get there. So, we will be there in half an hour. When will we be there? Where would he like to sleep? Well, I don't know, but he is very choosy and picky. He can't sleep here and he can't sleep in the living room. I think he would like to sleep in your bedroom. Where would he like to sleep? How did you sleep? I slept very well, thank you. Your bed is very comfortable. How did you sleep? Do you want to order? Actually, not. We haven't decided yet, so can we have a moment, please? Do you want to order? This is a present for you. Whoa, what's this? What is this in this beautiful box with a ribbon? What's that? It's a present for you. This is a present for you. What a nice present. I'm delighted. I like it very much. Thank you very much. What a nice present. Are your parents strict? Well, now they are not strict, but when I was younger, they were very strict. Are your parents strict? That's not a problem. Can you please help me? I can't start my car. That's not a problem. I'm a mechanic. I'll help you. It is not healthy. Smoking is not healthy. It is not healthy. It is important to eat healthy. What is important to you? It is important to eat healthy. Are you going to put your coat on? No, I'm not. It's warm outside. Are you going to put your coat on? I will visit a doctor today. Why? Are you not feeling well? What's wrong with you? I will visit a doctor today. Some of the neighbors are not friendly. What do you think about your new neighbors? Well, some of them are not very friendly. They go for a walk in the park. What do they usually do in the afternoon? What do your parents usually do in the afternoon? Well, they go for a walk in the park. What time does your English lesson begin? My English lesson begins at 8. What time does your English lesson begin? Do you have any change? No, sorry, I don't have any money with me. Do you have any change? Is your passport here? No, it's not, but I would like to travel with you. Is your passport here? Where did he live before? I don't know where he lived before. Where did he live before? What time is he coming? I think he's coming at 8. What time is he coming? Where should we go? I don't know. I think we should go to the cinema. Where should we go? Where are the glasses? The glasses are in the kitchen, I guess. Why do you need glasses? I want to drink wine. Where are the glasses? A bottle of mineral water, please. Hello, sir. What would you like to drink? A bottle of mineral water, please. Certainly, sir. Why are you waiting here? Why aren't you waiting inside? It's cold outside. Why are you waiting here? They're very busy. I doubt they can help you. They are very busy. I don't understand the modern art. What about you? What do you think of this picture? Do you like it? I don't understand the modern art. Wake me up at 6. Why should I wake you up at 6? Well, I have an appointment with my doctor. Wake me up at 6. That is good for you. Yes, I know. Getting up early is good. That's good for you. The yard is full of children. Where are all the children? They are in the yard. The yard is full of children playing. How long is the flight? I think the flight takes 3 hours. It's a long flight. How long is the flight? My kitchen is small, but beautiful. I like it. It's beautiful, but it's a bit too small for me. I think I need a bigger kitchen. My kitchen is small, but beautiful. That would be really cool. What would be cool? If you pick me up and then we go together somewhere, we go out together. That would be really cool. I would like that. That would be cool. Can I exchange it? Why do you want to exchange your present? You don't like it? No, I don't like these earrings. I want to exchange them. Can I exchange it? Will we go for a walk? Well, yes. Why not? Let's go for a walk. It's a beautiful day outside. Will we go for a walk? Can we afford a new car? Well, I'm not sure whether we can afford a new car, but we need a new car. Our old car is broken. Can we afford a new car? We can't afford to go abroad this summer. I'm so sorry, but we have to save some money and then we will have to stay at home. We can't afford to go abroad this summer. You obviously have an idea. I can see that. I can see that by the look in your eyes. You obviously have an idea. She didn't even call to say she wasn't coming. It was so rude of her. I invited her to my party, she didn't show up, and she didn't even call to say she wasn't coming. I think he's an honest man. Do you think he's telling the truth? Well, I do. I think he's an honest man. I'm sure that he's an honest man. I doubt that he was able to do such a thing, because I know that he's an honest man and I'm sure that he is an honest man. He couldn't have done such a thing. I don't doubt your honesty. Do you think I'm lying to you? No, I don't. I don't doubt your honesty. You can count on his honesty. You can believe him. He will keep his promise. You can count on his honesty. The decision was theirs, and it wasn't imposed on them by others. Why did they decide to do that? Were they persuaded to do that? No, they were not persuaded or forced to do that. The decision was theirs, and it wasn't imposed on them by others. I'm concerned for Anna's safety. She's out there alone. I'm concerned for her safety. That's my concern. I'm her father, and that's my concern. I will make sure that she comes home safe. I will make sure that she comes home safe.